Hello friends, in previous video we have studied various terms and definitions related to city. Then previous to that we have also studied the construction and working of the city. In this video we are going to study the accuracy class of city. Basically city, that is current transformer, it is nothing but an instrument transformer. So it works either as a measuring instrument or it works in conjunction with the protective relaying system. Now the primary winding of the CT has large number of turns, whereas the number of turns of the secondary winding are relatively very small. So CT is basically the step down transformer. The accuracy of CT will be determined on how the CT produces the primary current in terms of secondary current. So let us study the accuracy class of the CT. The accuracy class of CT is determined by how accurately the CT reproduces primary current in the secondary winding. Now the accuracy class is assigned to CT with the specified limits of ratio error and phase angle error. Now we have already studied what is ratio error and phase angle error. So in terms of the ratio error and phase angle error, the accuracy class of the CT can be specified. Now the accuracy of current transformer is expressed in terms of departure from its ratio from its true value. So whether there is a departure of the ratio from true value to the actual value, depending on that the accuracy class of the CT can be specified. This phenomenon is basically called as ratio error and it is expressed by the formula percentage error is equal to n multiplied by is minus ip divided by is multiplied by 100, where n is nothing but the nominal ratio, which is equal to rated primary current divided by rated secondary current. Now if you want to express it in terms of the turns, then we can write it is equal to so this n can also be specified in number of turns. So the formula becomes n is equal to number of secondary turns divided by number of primary turns. If you compare n, that is a nominal transformation ratio, with the transformation ratio of our regular transformer, you will find that it is exactly the reciprocal of the transformation ratio of the regular transformer. Then is is the value of secondary current. And IP is the value of primary current. Now basically the ratio error of the CT depends upon its exciting current. Exciting current is the one which is the phasor addition of the working component current and the magnetizing current. When the primary current increases, the CT will try to produce the corresponding secondary current. This requires greater secondary EMF than core flux density and exciting current. Now, as the primary winding is having greater number of turns, obviously the voltage in the primary winding will be high as compared to the secondary winding. Now during this process, one stage comes when any further increase in the primary current is almost wholly absorbed in the increasing exciting current. So if we go on increasing the primary winding current, whatever increase in the current will be absorbed by the exciting current, that is I0. As a result of this, secondary current will not increase at all. At this stage, the CT goes in the saturation. The ratio error basically depends upon the saturation of CT. CT will be saturated when the primary current increases, but there is no rise in the secondary current. This is because of the fact that even though the primary current increases, this whole current will be absorbed by the exciting current, that is I0. As a result, there is no rise in the secondary current. At this stage, the current transformer will go into saturation. Now an accuracy of about 2% to 3% of CT is desirable for the distance and differential relays, whereas other percentage may be tolerated for the other relays. Now, according to the standard which is followed in UK, the protective CT are classified into following types. First is S type, second is T type, third is U type. Now here there is one table which shows the various values for the CT errors as per the class of CT. So let us study this table. So for S class of CT, the ratio error is 3%. Then the ratio of I0 to I saturation here . So the ratio of I0 to I saturation for S class of CT is 3%. Then the phase angle error in degrees is 2 degree. Similarly, if you consider T class of CT, then for this class, ratio error is about 5%. Then the ratio of I0 to I saturation is 10%, whereas the phase angle error is 6 degrees. Now, if you consider U class of CT, then ratio error is about 15%. Then the ratio of I0 to I saturation is about 15%, whereas the phase angle error in degrees is 9 degrees. When a primary current increases, at a certain value the core begins to saturate and the error will also go on increasing. This value of primary current, at which the error reaches a specific limit, is known as the limit current or saturation current. The maximum value of primary current for the given accuracy class is always specified by the manufacturer. So while designing the CT, manufacturer will mention what is the value of maximum primary current. The CT will maintain accuracy at the specified maximum primary current at the rated burdens. So whenever there is load on CT, that is burden on CT, the CT will try to maintain this rated primary current which is already specified by the manufacturer. This current is basically expressed in multiples of the rated current. Now the ratio of accuracy limit, primary current and the rated current is known as rated accuracy limit factor or the saturation factor. The standard value for this factor are 5, 10, 15, 20 and 30. In this way, we have studied accuracy class of current transformer, that is CT. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.